Good morning, my dear students. Welcome to the social science class. How are you all? Fine. I hope you all are fine. Okay. Today we are going to start our second block, block 2, work and play. Block 2, work and play. Work and play. As you know that we all have different kinds of needs, right? Do you know what are the basic needs of the human being? As a human, we have different kinds of need. I think that you have already studied in the previous classes, EBS, in your EBS, right? Yes, that we have studied what are the basic needs. What are the basic needs? Yes, water, air, food, and shelter. These are our basic need. Without these basic need, we can't live, isn't it? Yes, without air, how can we live? Without water, how can we live? Without food, it is not possible. So, all these needs are very important to us. Without this, we can't live. So, we have different needs. We need water, we need food, we need shelter, and we need clothes. In order to meet this need, we have to do something. In order to meet these needs, we have to do some things. We have to do some work. That is, work means, what is work? Something we all have to do. Something we all have to do. Something we all have to do is known as work. Understand? We all of us doing some work at our home, right? Today we are going to discuss different kinds of work at home. Work we do at home. Our aim of this lesson is to list the work done by family members. To list the aim of our lesson is to list the work done by the family members. Our lesson name is Lesson 1, Work We Do at Home. Work we do at home. We are doing different kinds of work at home. This work is also known as household chores. What is it? Household chores. Household chore. Household chores. Who does household work in your family? Who does the household chores or household work in your family? What's your answer? Your parents, your sister, your brother, and we all are doing different type of work at home. Each members of the family doing different job, different work at home. There are different types of work at home to meet our needs. Okay, so everyone in the family, we all are doing some work at home. This is known as household chores. So household chore is part of our daily life. We are doing this work every day, right? These kinds of work, some works we do at our home every day. Every members are helping each other and sharing, and we are doing some works at home every day, right? Sometimes our parents, our grandparents, our brother, sister, all are doing these household works. So this is part of our daily life. Some people don't enjoy doing this work, but still have to do. Some people in some family, they hire others to help them. They hire others to help them. In some family, they are doing that work within the family. That means they are divide the work among the family members. All the family members are doing the works. So let us start our first lesson from this blog is work we do at a home. We will discuss in this chapter what are the different kinds of work people do in the family. Okay, we have to read a story. We can read it together because all of you have workbook with you, right? Do you have workbook? Okay, please take your workbook and block 2. Here block 2, S1. The work we do at home. The work we do at home. Please open it. We can read the story about a family. It's about Diaz family. I will read it. All of you read silently and listen it. Mama is the first to wake up every morning. She takes out the garbage. Then she makes tea for Papa, Grandma and Grandpa. She wakes up my brother Deepak and me with a cup of milk each, and we get ready for school. Mama makes our breakfast and tiffin. Papa gets milk from the milk both. Grandpa waters the plants and takes us to the bus stop. He buys vegetable on his way home. Grandma makes us lunch after school and tells us a story while we eat. Deepak and I finish our homework before going out to play. Mama and Papa come back together from work at 6 p.m. Mama makes dinner and Papa comes out to play with us. I always set the table for dinner and Deepak helps Papa and Mama clear it after dinner. Sometimes I watch television with my grandma after dinner. Mama switches off our lights at night when we go to bed. I will read once again. Listen carefully. Mama is the first to wake up every morning. She takes out the garbage. Then she makes tea for Papa, Grandma and Grandpa. She wakes up my brother Deepak and me with a cup of milk each. And we get ready for school. Mama makes our breakfast and tiffin. Papa gets milk from the milk booth. Grandpa waters the plant and takes us to the bus stop. He buys vegetable on his way home. Grandma makes us lunch after school and tells us a story while we eat. Deepak and I finish our homework before going out to play. Mama and Papa come back together from work at 6 p.m. Mama makes dinner and Papa comes out to play with us. I always set the table for dinner. And Deepak helps Papa and Mama clear it after dinner. Sometimes I watch television with my grandma after dinner. Mama switches off our light and at night when we go to bed. Okay, we have read the story or passage about Dia's family. We can understand that there are different kinds of work done by each members in the family, right? Yes. Every day Dia set the table for dinner. What about her brother? Her brother cleaning the table after eating the dinner. And her brother help her mother, his mother and father. Every members, grandpa, grandma, mama, papa, all the family members have some works at home. They are doing this work every day. Isn't it? Yes. Here Dia set the table, her brother cleaned the table after eating. Every day it's their duty. Then grandma make lunch and snacks for them. Papa gets milk from the milk shop, gets milk, and grandpa watering the plants. What about ma? What about their mother? Mother had a lot of duty. Mother had a lot of work. Mother had a lot of work in their family. She first wake up and she makes breakfast and tiffin for them, and she also make dinner. At last she switch off light at night. So mother had a lot of duty, and everyone, Dia, her brother, her grandma, grandpa, father, mother, all the family members done different work at home. So we can understand that at the same time this type of work we are also doing in our family, right? Yes. Can you say what are the different types of works we do at home? Works we do at home. What are the different kinds of works we do at home? Can you say? Anyone can say? It is very simple that you have already studied that household chores. What are the works we do at our home? What are the works? For example, in Dia's family, you can take that example, Dia's family, and say, what are the different types of works done by each person in Dia's family? Dia, what she done in her family? Yes, Dia made or set the table. Set the table. Then, any other? Then, watering plants. Her grandpa watering the plants. Then cleaning room. Then anything else? Yes, washing dishes and washing clothes. Anything else? These all work we have to do to meet our needs. One more is there. Anybody can say? We have to buy something from the market. Sometime our parent in Diyas, in case of Diya, who is doing that work? Her grandpa. Grandpa buys vegetable. Buy vegetables. Vegetables and what we have to make the food, what we needed to make the food, all of us needed to buy. Needed buy vegetables, set the table, watering the plants, washing clothes and cleaning room, washing dishes. These are the different types of household work we have to do. When we do these household chores only, we will get our needs. To meet our needs, we have to do these household chores. Why do we need to do? Everyone have to do this household work? Why does everyone in the family have to do this household work? Why? Everyone in the family have to do this household work? Because in a family there are lot of works at home. So every family members help and share each other in completing this household work. Do all these families run in same way? Yes or no? Most of the families have this household chores and they divided the household chores among the members. They divided the work among the family members. What would happen when the work are not done? What would happen when this household works are not done in our family? Please imagine what would happen in our family, this kind of works are not done. Yes, when we not done this work, our house become dirty. It makes our house dirty and it makes our house disorganized. That means some things are there and some things are here, like that. There is no order. Understand? So this is very important. Every members of the family have to do this household work. Then only we will meet our needs. Do you understand this first lesson? In this first lesson from the block 2, our block name is Work and Play. The first lesson we have studied that work we do at home. Everyone have different kinds of work at home. We have to do, everyone of the family members have to do this work. Which are the kinds of work we do at home? Buy vegetables, cleaning rooms, washing dishes, set the table, watering the plants and washing clothes. These are the some types of works we do at home. Everyone of the family need to do this work because a lot of work to do in the family. We help and share each other in completing this household work. Okay? Do you understand this portion? What are the different kinds of household work we done at our home? Okay, let us move to the next topic. I hope you all understood what are the different kinds of work we do at home. Understand? Okay, let's move to the next topic.
Okay.
We have listed the different kinds of work done by the each family members in the Yas family. The same as our family also, we listed some household works done by the family members. Then now we will learn about what work we do at our home and how everyone can help. What work we do at our home and how everyone can help. So our aim is to describe the importance of sharing work. Sharing work. Should child do the household work? Can you doing any household work? Yes, children should do some work. They can help their family. Children can do some common work. Which are the works they can do? Which are the tasks you can do as a child? Which are the tasks you can do? As a child, you can do some common work. Which are there some common works? Such as making our bed every day morning. Making our bed every day morning. Then keep all our things, that means keep our books and toys at a right place. As a child, we should do something and help our parents. We can do some common things. Which are they? We can make our bed every day morning. We can keep our books and toys at a right place. If we do not clear our study table, what would happen? If we do not clear our study table, it will make a dirty. Our study table will be dirty and we will lose our things. So it is our duty to make or clean our study table and make the bed every day and keep our things or keep toys and our books at a right place. So you can do and you can help your parents or family members to do this household work. So today we are going to discuss about sharing household work. Sharing household work. Sharing work at home. Sharing work at home. Why do we need to share the work at home? Do we need to share the work at home? Yes, we need to share the work at home. Why? Because there is a lot of work. We know that in our homes, there are lot of work to be done. One person can't do that work. A lot of work to be done. Lot of work to be done. A lot of work to be done. One person, most families, women or our mothers, they are doing most of the work. They have a lot of works at home, right? Yes. They have a lot of work at home. So one person can't do all this work alone. One person can't do all this work alone. So we have to help each other and share the work. One person can't do or work at home. One person can't do all works at home. What we have to do, what other members have to do, other family members, all the family members help and they share. They have to share the family, they have to share the household work at home, and they have to help each other. Here, a lot of work to be done. A person can't do all work, so they needed help. They needed help for completing the household work. Completing the household work. So every members in the family help each other, then only complete our household works. Okay. Needed help for completing the household chores. If we help each other, if we share, when we share the household chores, the work gets done faster. If we share the work, work gets done faster. Work done faster. If we share the household work or work at home, the work gets done faster. And every family members get a time to have a fun. What would happen if your parents fall sick? What would happen if your parents fall sick? How would you help your parents? What would happen if your parents fall sick? How would you help them? How would you help them? If our parents fall sick, all the works done at our family will stuck. It stop or get disturbed. All the works in the family or all the works in the home get stop or get disturbed when our parents falls sick or ill. What we have to do at that time, our parents fall sick, all the works we need to do. What we have to do at that time, our parents fall sick. When our parents fall sick, every members are ready to divide the works among the members. Every members ready to divide the works among the family members. So it is our duty is to share the household chores. So all the family members help each other and share each other for completing the household chores. Do you understand this topic? This is the second lesson, L2. Sharing works at home. What is our aim? To describe the importance of sharing work. To describe the importance of sharing work. Sharing work is very important. As a children should help the parents. How can they help? They can do something. Children can do some common things. Which are they that we have discussed? Which are they? Yes, we can make our beds. We can keep our things in proper place or a right place. That things means toys and book. We can keep it a proper or right place. If we do not clean our study table, it will make dirty and our things also will loss. So we have to take care and share the household work. So why do we need to share the household work? Do we need to share the household work? Yes, we need to share the household work because a lot of work to be done at home. A lot of work to be done at home. One person can't do all this work at home. One person can't do all this work at home. So everyone help each other. They needed, family members need help for completing household work. And if we share the works, works get done faster, and every members of the family get time to have fun. So we have to share the household chores for completing the household work, and we will get time to have fun. Are you ready to do? Okay. I hope you all understood these two lessons. Do you understand? Okay. What did you learn today? In this class, we have started our second block, block 2, work and play. And we have discussed our first lesson. What was the first lesson? First lesson, work we do at home. There are different kinds of work we do at home. That we have read a story, and we can understand that in every family there are different, a lot of work we have to do. Then sharing, second lesson, sharing works at home. There are a lot of work at home, so we have to share our household work. In order to meet our needs, we have to do this household work. A lot of work we have to do at home. So a person can't do all this work. So they needed everyone's help. If we share the works, it will get done faster. It gets done faster, and we will get time to spend fun. Okay, so I hope all of you understood these two lessons from the block 2. Okay, thank you. See you in the next class. We will discuss more about the work and play in the next class. See you next class.